The U.S. Navy's top aviator has indicated that the service's new unmanned aerial tanker will be flying this year and operating off aircraft carriers in 2026, characterizing it as a key point in paving the way for future next-generation aircraft. Vice Admiral Daniel Cheever, commander of Naval Air Forces, told an audience at West in San Diego, "We'll fly MQ-25 in 25. You can quote me on that. We'll fly that platform in 25 and get that thing on a carrier in 26 and start integrating it. That unlocks the future of manned, unmanned teaming." He continued, "We're going after that thing in a big way so we can do manned, unmanned teaming off an aircraft carrier, and that's a different world. It opens up the future of 6th-gen collaborative combat aircraft and everything that comes after it." He added, "I don't see a lot of issues bringing it together. I'm just going to turn the weapons tactics instructors loose, and they'll exactly figure out how to operate this thing seamlessly in a manned-unmanned teaming environment. So I'm pretty excited for that, because we need that capability, and we need it this year to start flying." In this video, Defense Updates reports on the MQ-25 Stingray aerial tanker potentially getting operational by 2026. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. To counter Western domination, countries like Russia and China have deployed long-range anti-ship missiles such as DF-26 and sophisticated air defense systems like S-400 as part of the Anti-Access and Area Denial, or A2AD, strategy. These missiles would make it risky for American supercarriers to enter the battle zone. It means that carrier-based aircraft will find it difficult to carry out their missions as they have a finite range limited by fuel capacity. This is where the MQ-25 Stingray comes in. The platform can offset this problem since the tactical aircraft can be launched from further away, limiting the risk to the carriers. Upon becoming operational, these drones will autonomously operate from the decks of America's Nimitz and Ford-class carriers, meeting returning fighters to refuel them and extend their range. Boeing MQ-25 Stingray is an aerial refueling drone that resulted from the Carrier-Based Aerial Refueling System (CBARS) program. The primary role of the Stingray drones will be to provide crucial aerial refueling support to the Navy's carrier air wings. Additionally, these drones possess the capability to operate in a secondary role, undertaking intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions as needed. In October 2017, the U.S. Navy released the final MQ-25 Stingray RFP. The Navy's goal for the aircraft is to be able to deliver 15,000 pounds, that's about 6,800 kilograms of fuel total, to 4 to 6 airplanes at a range of 930 kilometers or 580 miles. The competitors were Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, General Atomics, and Boeing. Lockheed Martin put on the table their Sea Ghost design based on the RQ-170 Sentinel. Northrop Grumman initially proposed X-47B, but later withdrew, stating it wouldn't be able to execute the program under the terms of the service's request for proposals. General Atomics proposed the Sea Avenger concept, which is an enlarged version of the Avenger drone customized for air refueling. Boeing came into the competition with a full-fledged prototype derived from its Phantom Ray demonstrator, which ultimately won. The contract is worth $13 billion, as around 72 such drones will be inducted in total. Over the years, Boeing has been engaged in extensive testing of the MQ-25 demonstrator, referred to as T-1, bearing the U.S. Civil Registration Code N-234MQ. These tests formed a crucial part of Boeing's ongoing efforts to develop the initial production representative prototypes of the Stingray for the U.S. Navy. In 2021, T-1 successfully underwent integration into the carrier environment during a demonstration aboard the USS George H.W. Bush, CVN-77. While the MQ-25 design is less stealthy than a flying wing UAV, it does feature a stealthy fuselage shaping, a flush inlet to shield engine blades from radar, and a V-tail. Boeing's MQ-25 design is powered by one Rolls-Royce AE-3007N turbofan engine, delivering 10,000 pound force, or 44 kilonewtons, of thrust. This is a variant of the engine used to power the Navy's MQ-4C Triton. The MQ-25 has 15,000 pounds of fuel ready for offloading within an 800-mile or 1,290-kilometer range. It will significantly extend the combat range of deployed F/A-18 Super Hornet, EA-18G Growler, and Lockheed Martin F-35C combat aircraft. Viewers may note that air-to-air refueling by default is a complex procedure where aircraft have to fly in close proximity, so refueling of a piloted aircraft by an unmanned tanker is a major technological feat. Additionally, the MQ-25s are expected to be integral in conducting intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance (ISR) missions for the Navy. MQ-25 Stingray getting operational will be one of the key developments for the U.S. Navy and the U.S. military as a whole. The MQ-25's significance lies in its ability to address the challenges posed by vast operational distances, particularly in regions like the Pacific. By effectively doubling the range of tactical fighters, it provides a strategic advantage that could redefine aerial operations in the area. Moreover, the MQ-25 seamlessly aligns with the Navy's broader vision for carrier-based aviation. The U.S. Navy is actively working to expand the role of unmanned aircraft on carriers, anticipating that air wings will be primarily composed of unmanned systems within the next decade. Currently, the Navy is targeting a 40-60 split between unmanned and manned aircraft, with a long-term objective of shifting to a 60-40 balance in favor of unmanned platforms. It will be interesting to see if Stingray actually comes online by 2026.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.